Iron deficiency. So many people are struggling with overcoming iron deficiency, and a completely overlooked cause of iron deficiency and the ability to refurbish your iron stores is non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. Non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is a state where the liver is literally accumulating fat, tissue is turning to fat in the liver, and that is not caused by excess alcohol intake. That's why we call it non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. And this affects over 100 million people in the United States alone. And each year, the incidence is just going up, 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 up. And this condition, where fat builds up in the liver in place of highly productive and metabolically active liver tissue, you know, tissue that would be used for protein formation, for hormone metabolism, for detoxification, it can't do any of that anymore. And we have these people who are iron deficient, spludging their body with iron, wondering why they're not getting any results. Because they got raging inflammation in the body. And then the majority of people with non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, they don't even know it. They don't know they have it. You know, you can check your AST, your ALT, your GGT on your lab test, great test. And you can see, are those high, or are those on the high end of normal? This could suggest fatty liver disease, and often does. You can also get, you know, a liver ultrasound, which could show, you know, do I have fat sitting in my liver? Or you can recognize, I can recognize, that non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is not seen anywhere in the world except where there is a high consumption of processed and packaged foods. Welcome to the standard American diet. You know, if you eat prepared foods, TV dinners, fast food, Smart Mart food, drink soda pops, you know, you're eating Ritz crackers, chips, artificial creamers in your coffee, drinking out of, you know, plastic single-use bottled waters, you can rest assured you probably have non-alcoholic fatty liver disease going on. Your liver is building fat. It is losing its metabolic capacity and becoming just this blob of inefficiency. Now, this is going to make it extremely challenging to get your iron levels up when you have fatty liver, because inflammation is going to be elevated. And inflammation, what's that do? It turns down iron absorption. The body does not absorb iron in a state of inflammation. Non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, it is a state of chronic low-grade inflammation, devouring literally the most prized organ in the human body that supports detoxification, that supports elimination clearance. This is why taking a whole person approach is paramount to overcoming iron deficiency. People will say, you know, there's not enough iron in blood vitality. It won't work for me. But what they fail to realize is that it is less about gobs of iron, and it's all about creating a state of homeostasis in the body. Balance. The body isn't just this one street that goes in. It is this thing, these interactions that are happening, you know, millions of them all together every second of every day. Just like overcoming diabetes, overcoming autoimmunity, overcoming depression, overcoming iron deficiency, it requires a holistic approach. Otherwise, you'll find yourself just running down rabbit trails, finding another group to get in, another group to get in, another group to get in, all with it, you know, a different, oh, just do this, just do that, just do this. And you're just going to be loaded down with frustration and just feel completely overwhelmed. Recognize you don't need to be obese to have an obese liver. I've seen countless individuals with normal body weight who had fatty livers. You could go on a, you know, crash diet, you know, lose a bunch of weight, but see no changes in your liver fat. Because the deal is, without removing yourself from the standard American eating pattern, it's just not about caloric reduction. We're talking about real food substance coming into the body and packaged, processed junk food not coming into the body, being eliminated. You will not resolve fatty liver. And you'll find yourself, like I said, frustrated. And if you're iron deficient, you're just gonna continue to suffer with iron deficiency. And if you have iron deficiency, you know performance lacks, right? Mental performance lacks, physical performance lacks, life performance lacks. And when you have non-alcoholic fatty liver disease in your body, iron overload is literally the state of the body. It feels like it's an iron overload, but you could actually be iron deficient because the body has induced this protective mechanism to help you out. So as you supplement to overcome iron deficiency, I would recommend with great veracity to exit the processed food highway and begin incorporating over and over and over again meats and eggs and fruits and vegetables every turn. How much whole food can you make your lifestyle? How much whole food? Can you get breakfast? Can you get lunch? Can you get dinner? Any of those snack items you're having, can those be whole foods? If you're iron deficient, rather than just thinking, okay, can I get a bunch of really high iron foods in my body? Think, can I get a bunch of real whole life-giving foods in my body? That is your goal. And then, you know, any supplementation you take on top of that, any iron you have in those foods, you're gonna get so much more results. And you're not gonna be bludgeoning your body with 100, 200, 300 milligrams of iron or, you know, insane amounts of copper or doing just all this craziness. You can take a very small amount of iron, a physiological dose, just like is in Blood Vitality, get massive results and be another amazing review. I'm Dr. Matt. Let me know your iron story, what's getting in your way. Love to hear it, and how you've overcome your own iron deficiency and have gotten beyond just, you know, bludgeoning yourself with iron and really have gotten past the state of iron deficiency. I'd love to hear it. Talk to you guys later.